What's up everyone, it's Pav here and welcome back to my channel. This video is gonna be about using pinch harmonics in solos. I don't see a lot of guitar players these days who use that technique, and the ones who use it, I think they do it intuitively, so they don't really talk about it much. And most of the time people relate pinch harmonics to heavy punchy riffs. The reason for that might be modern metal music or guitar instrumental music that comes out lately, or because it's easier to learn how to play pinch harmonic on lower string rather than on higher strings. But to me, using pinch harmonics in solos has always been something special. It brings so much color and contrast to your playing and makes your solo sound very bright and sparkly. And by listening to early 90s hard rock bands or instrumental guitar players, I've been noticing that this approach was all over the place back then. This type of sound could be done by using a sustainer in octave mode, or with feedback from the real amp, or sometimes with tap harmonics. And by example, with Joe Satriani, sometimes you hear that his sound is so edgy and it's somewhere in between the actual note and pinch harmonic. So for years I've been trying to figure out how do I achieve that kind of sound, and again, intuitively, I figured that pinch harmonics really do that for me. If you don't know how to play pinch harmonics, please pause this video and look up some tutorial on YouTube first. Go! Alright, welcome back. So I'm in D standard tuning, but it doesn't really matter that much for this video. And now I'm gonna show you the way I do it. So the working area for the left hand is somewhere in between 12th fret and 15th fret. I have 22 frets. If you have 24, it's just a couple of frets higher. So let's say I want to play a pinch harmonic on a third string on 12th fret. And I would imagine that the fretboard never ended and continued right up until somewhere around here. So I need to find an invisible 24th fret, which makes an octave from 12th fret. And I would start doing a pinch harmonic right away while looking for it. All right, we got it. So let's try a 15th fret on the second string now. And it's basically the same thing, but here you need to look for an invisible 27th fret. And a good thing is that after some time of practice, your right hand might eventually memorize the right exact spots for the pinch harmonics, right here. I think it sounds really cool when you apply that to soloing. Another approach that I mentioned in this video earlier is that edgy type of sound somewhere in between the actual note and pinch harmonic. For that, you don't need to necessarily look for an octave spot. You just go in a pinch harmonic mode by keeping your right thumb close to the string and just apply it here and there. As you could notice, the difference between these two methods is that with the octave approach, pinch harmonic replaces the note completely if it's done properly. But with the second approach, it's a mix between pinch harmonic and the actual note. I hope this information was useful for some of you guys. Take care and see you in the next videos. Peace.